Today, we're going to look at times and seasons and how God uses that to speak to us. I'll read for us from Ecclesiastes chapter 3, verses 1. To everything, there is a season, a time for every purpose under heaven. And verse 11, He has made everything beautiful in its time. Also, He has put eternity in their hearts, except that no one can find out the work that God does from beginning to end. And even in the book of Daniel, Daniel 2:21, God's word says, and He changes the times and the seasons. He removes kings and raises up kings. Okay, God changes the seasons of nature. But even in our lives, there are appointed times and seasons. And that's how God works. The appointed time, in the Greek it's called kairos. The kairos moment is when God moves. In Genesis 3:15, in the garden, God spoke and He said that He would send the seed of the woman to crush the serpent. And He was referring to Jesus Christ. But it wasn't until 4,000 years that Jesus came. And so there was a passage of time which we refer to as chronos in Galatians 4:4, that in the fullness of time, Jesus Christ was manifest. So God works in the fullness of the passing time, or God works in the fullness of chronos. And that is what we are calling kairos. 2 Chronicles 16, verse 9. For the eyes of the Lord run to and fro throughout the whole earth to show Himself strong on behalf of those whose heart is loyal to Him. Now, these scriptures are telling us that God is God. We talked about times and seasons and the right time. At the right time, God shows Himself powerful on behalf of those whose hearts are loyal to Him, those who have been trusting in Him and who have their faith in God. God shows His power in their lives. Job chapter 42 and verse 2. I know that you can do everything and that no purpose of yours can be withheld from you. Revelation 3:7 affirms the same word and it says, and to the angel of the church in Philadelphia write, these things says He who is holy, He who is true, He who has the key of David, He who opens and no one shuts, and shuts and no one opens. So God guides us through His power. He opens doors and He shuts doors. And when God is working in this way in our lives, with, of course, the confirmation of the word, we can identify the exact open door that we must walk through. Psalms 105 and verse 19. The last part of that passage, it says, the word of the Lord tested him. So Joseph went through so many things until the kairos moment arrived. The appointed time came and the tables turned. He went from being a prisoner to someone in authority. And then we know the rest of what happened. The day did come when he was serving his brothers from his position in Egypt. And God fulfilled the promise that he gave Joseph.